And I am back with another episode of Ragaparichay. This time we visit Rag Des. Des has a very, very special place in the mind of practically everybody. You know? Des probably is that one melody which is deeply ingrained in the soil of this country. And no wonder then that we have this in this. You know, the entire of this country wakes up to this particular tune, this particular, you know, dhun, Vande Mataram. And again, no wonder that a very popular social message in the 80s went like, this was a composition by the great Ashok Patki ji, and this became extremely, extremely popular. This was one of the most popular social messages of that decade. So now let's look at this from closer quarters. This, and there is another person, Sorat. So this came out of a rag called Sorat. And Sorat went something like, Sorat was very, very, very close to what this is today. So Sorat probably came out of Sarang. Sare ma pa ni sa. This is the aro of Sara. Doesn't have the ga. This ga between the mare, mare. The ga is hidden in this mean in Sorat. All that this does is it brings out this Gandhar and makes it stand on its own. So you have a des which is so very different from Sorat, and you know, Sorat is probably no more sung in Mahfils. Des has taken over its place. So this is the character of des. Sa re re re. The guy is pronounced re ma ga re. And then it continues like so. Connection is very, very, very prominent. It is the character of Desh and also Swara. Dhamma gare, rema padama gare, dhamma gare, ganisa, nisare re, rema ma pa ma pa. So with this connection, pani dhapa re ma ga re. You know, we've been talking about congruent phrases, and this is a beautiful example of what happens. And this is this.